My name is Buffalo Nichols, and I'm a musician here in Austin, Texas. I've always been sort of a, you know, emotional person, as I think we all should be. And for me, music starts with the emotions. Certain emotions are more socially acceptable than others, you know. So things like joy and love, you can kind of share that with other people and express it, and everybody's sort of okay with it. But, you know, the less desirable emotions, you're kind of often expected to deal with that on your own. So I think music is the place that I go to sort of, you know, sort that stuff out. I try not to describe myself if I can help it, but sometimes if I want to keep the conversation short, I'll just say, hey, I play the blues, yeah. I could be your place to hide, I'd tell you the sweetest lies. Is Buffalo Nichols a blues artist? I would say no, but I made a blues album, so that's easy. Usually people stop talking after that, they're like, oh, well, let me get out of here. I think the reason why I was drawn to the Resonator is the same reason why blues musicians were sort of gravitating toward it. It was the volume of it. I was always sort of like interested in slide guitar playing, but I never bothered really getting into it because like it requires your guitar to be set up in a certain way. I just never bothered. And then finally I just was like, I'm gonna get a dedicated guitar for a slide, and it has a sort of like vocal quality to it. And to me, that's really what the blues is all about, you know, the singing. So I was like, I want to have an instrument that's like a backup singer. You know, I try really hard to be an original thinker in my creative life, which is like, can probably seem pretty ironic that I made an album that's pretty like contrived and not very different. But yeah, I think the originality comes from the character of the artist, not necessarily the output. And I had all these sort of different expectations and goals that I set for myself, and the goals never are what you think they are, and they never come when you would like them. Success is a sort of, it needs to be very movable, because if you have this sort of defined idea of what it is, when you get there, you're kind of setting yourself up for failure. If I had to look back and ask, you know, was I successful? I think if I could make it easier for other people to be themselves and to move freely and to be creative, then I think that would be, you know, I'd be happy with that. Great way to put it. I just made all that up. I don't believe any of that, but I think it sounds coherent enough. Let's go with it.